Hello friends, welcome to Cat Maniac. This is Itabo. Very recently, the channel has reached 1000 subscribers, so I would like to congratulate all the viewers and the subscribers for that. So keep supporting the channel to get more and more cat related videos. In this tutorial, we will learn how we can create this block. So without further delay, let's get started. This is Southeast Isometric view. You can click at this corner or click here to get into Southeast Isometric view. First of all, I'll create a box of 88 units length, 50 units width, and 56 units depth. So click on box tool, click anywhere in the drawing area, then click on length in the command line, move the cursor towards positive x-axis, and specify the length as 88 units and press enter. Then move the cursor towards positive y-axis, specify the width as 50 units, then press enter. Then move the cursor towards positive z-axis, and specify the depth as 56 units and press enter to create the box. Now I'll draw this line at an angle of 45 degrees in the front face. So click on line tool. Now turn on the dynamic UCS, press function key F6 to do that. As you can see, this face is highlighted. So click at this endpoint snap, then turn on the polar, click here or press F10, then click at this downwards arrow. Then set the polar function at 45 degrees interval. It's already set. As you can see, a green extensor line is showing whenever the line is at 45 degrees interval. Then come to this point and take an extension towards positive x-axis. Then click at the intersection of both the extensions. Then click at this corner and then click at this corner and press enter to exit from the line command. Now I'll create a box of 38 units length, 12 units width, and 38 units depth. So click on box tool, turn off the dynamic UCS, and then click at this corner. Then click on length in the command line, turn on the ortho, move the cursor towards positive x-axis, specify the length as 38 units, then move the cursor towards positive y-axis, and then specify the width as 12 units. Now move the cursor downwards and specify the depth as 38 units and press enter to create the box. Now I'll create another box of 38 units length, 28 units width, and 38 units depth. So click on box tool again, click at this corner snap, click on length in the command line, make sure the ortho is on, then move the cursor towards positive x-axis, specify the length as 38 units, press enter, then move the cursor towards positive y-axis, then specify the width as 28 units, press enter. Now move the cursor downwards and specify the depth as 38 units again and press enter to create this box. Now change the visual style to 2D wireframe so that the object selection gets easier. Now select both these boxes. I'll mirror these with respect to mid of this bigger box. So click on 3D mirror tool, then click at this midpoint snap, turn on the ortho so that the mirroring doesn't get wrong. Then click at this midpoint snap and then at this point and press enter to mirror the boxes. Now click on subtract tool, select this box, press enter, then select all the other boxes and press enter to subtract the smaller boxes from the bigger one. Now change the visual style to realistic again to get the realistic view. Now I'll slice this part with respect to the vertices of the triangle. So click on slice tool, select this part, press enter, click on three points in the command line, and then click at the three vertices as shown and press enter to slice this part. Now select the sliced parts and the triangle and press delete to delete this. As you can see, this is complete now. I hope you have enjoyed this video. So this is it for this video guys. Bye bye.